everybody, JC here with another T&I toy review. And today's review is in association with MarvelousNews.com, your number one news source for everything Marvel. And today we're going to take a look at the new Marvel Superhero Mashers Iron Man vs. Ironmonger Mash Pack 2-Pack. Now this set comes packaged in the same style of packaging that we see with all the Superhero Mashers from Hasbro. You've got the conglomerate of showing the mix and match parts of a figure off to the side, the Superhero Mashers logo down below. The figures are clearly displayed in the window box packaging, and then off on the left side you have the name of the pack, which is Iron Man versus Ironmonger. Then on the back of the packaging, we have a look at the figures with mixed and match parts. You've got Iron Man saying, well, at least spare parts are getting easier to find. And then you've got Ironmonger who says, smashing heroes to pieces means more gear for me. And then off to the side, you've got to look at other figures. These are the other two packs that have been released, Loki versus Hulk and Spider-Man versus Doc Ock. And then the Iron Man versus Ironmonger. Okay, so let's get this open and take a look at what's inside. So here's a look at the figures outside of the packaging. Now, we've gotten a number of Iron Mans released in this line over the past year. This version of Iron Man is based on what I call the classic Iron Man, the yellow and red armor. And then we've got Ironmonger, which is probably the figure that's most appealing about this set, at least to me. Of course, if you are trying to build like a hall of armor of Masher Iron Man figures, then you probably definitely would want to get this one as well. But the Ironmonger is the cooler of the two figures, in my opinion. So first off, we'll take a look at the Iron Man figure. And the figure is basically done in a bright red color with yellow, which I guess is supposed to be really gold, but it's a yellow paint that they've used. And the red on this is a bright red. It's much brighter than the other Iron Man figures that they've done. Now the attached pieces that he comes with are darker red, so they don't quite match the red on the actual figure. But you know, like with all the figures, he comes with a number of accessories, like a large gun, which has a firing rocket. You just push the button on the top and it fires off, and it fires pretty good. You know, we've seen that feature with a lot of these figures. You know, it goes without saying that this line is geared for young kids, not adults, even though I do think adults can find some enjoyment with this line, especially if they're, you know, introducing their kids to Marvel with these figures. He's also got these side rocket, I don't know if they're supposed to be jets or rockets, but they're not, you know, the rockets or jets, whatever these are at the tips, are not removable. They look more like rockets to me, but they basically fit on the side of his arms, though technically you can put them anywhere on the figure. You can put them down here on his legs, anywhere where there's a hole in the figure, you can attach these things. But like it depicts it on the box, you know, these on his arm. And he comes with two of those. And then he's got this jetpack that fits on his back. Now, when I first saw this in the packaging, my actual first thought was this was a glider. And it does kind of work as a glider if you wanted it to. And in fact, if you have that Masher's Green Goblin figure, which did not come with a glider, to me this is kind of would be a nice fill-in for that figure and does actually work with it. So finally, this Iron Man figure on his right arm has this blade thing. Now this unfortunately is not removable. It's kind of cool looking, but it doesn't really scream Iron Man to me. So I think it would have been better if it had been removable, but it's not. So hopefully, you know, maybe we'll get a regular Iron Man fist and packaged with one of the other figures down the line. Because the red is brighter, the other figures that have been released that have red hands don't quite match this figure. So, I mean, you could certainly swap it out with another red hand if you wanted to, but I don't think it would be exactly the same red. So here's a look at the Ironmonger figure close up. And as I said before, I think this is the cooler of the two figures in the set. I really like the overall look of the figure. I think they've captured the Ironmonger look in this Masher line pretty nicely. For the paint, they've used a blue basically for the entire figure, and it's got this kind of marbleized black wash throughout Most noticeably, you can see it on his legs and then on the side of his arms, especially in the light. And I think it looks pretty cool. And then he's got the darker maroon red for his unibeam and eyes. He's got this little antenna on his one shoulder, which is made with a flexible rubber type material. So it shouldn't break off terribly easy if your kid's playing with it. You know, maybe if he really, really tried, you could snap it off. But for the most part, it seems to be pretty durable. And then like with Iron Man, he comes with a number of accessories. He's got this big giant hammer, which he can hold in his hand to, you know, mash things with. It's got the peg on the end for him to hold. And then it's also got a peg on the underside of it, so you can attach it to like the side of his arm if you wanted to, for like a fist. Give him that hammer fist look if you wanted to. And it's just hollowed out plastic. He's also got rocket launchers that attach to his back. And they just snap on the holes in his back. And then I really like the design on the back. You know, he's got these parts that kind of are sculpted on for armor pieces, some bolts or something. So I think the back looks nice. And then he's got these holes. I guess they're supposed to be like air vents or something on his shoulders. On the back of his arm or his fists, and down here on his ankles. So it looks pretty cool. And again, I think the design is pretty nice for this figure. And then finally, like with Iron Man, he has this blade on his one hand. It looks more like a claw actually than a blade, and the blade part is just a dark gray plastic, hard plastic. But the difference between Iron Man and Ironmonger is his is actually removable. It just attaches to the side of his arm. So you can actually put it on either hand. And again, if you don't like that, it's removable, unlike the Iron Man one, which was not removable. Ironmonger stands just a little bit under 7 inches tall. Now, the scale isn't a big thing with this line. Most of the figures are pretty much the same height. You can see Ironmonger is a little bit, maybe a hair taller than Iron Man. Certainly not in the scale as you would see like in the comics, but you know, he is definitely bulkier than Iron Man. So, you know, they have made attempt to kind of make him a little bit bigger than the regular Iron Man figure, which I like. Articulation is pretty much the same with what we've seen with the other figures in this line, and it's pretty good articulation. Basically, these are put together with ball joints. So he's got, you know, they've got good up movement. They can look up really good, can look down, left and right. Arms, basically, as good rotation. Monger, you can't really get his arms out because of the way the armor is sculpted. With like Iron Man, you can get his arm out, but not with Ironmonger. No midsection articulation on these things. The legs are attached with ball hinge joints, so they have pretty good movement. Rotation, ball joints again at the knees, and rotation. Now, Ironmonger does not have any ankle articulation, unfortunately. Iron Man does. He's got the ankle pivots, like we've seen with the other Iron Man figures in the line. So, he's got that added articulation there. Here's for the elbows. They, again, just have those ball hinge joints, and they've got the rotation at the elbow. No wrist articulation on these. Real quick, I'll just go over, you know, the basic concept of these is you can take apart the figures down to the main body part, and then you can mix and match pieces with other figures. So if you wanted to give a red Iron Man hand to Ironmonger, you know, you can, and they all the parts are interchangeable, and they just snap in. You can give him the Tony Stark head that came with that first Iron Man figure released in the line. You can attach the, we'll keep his Ironmonger legs. And then give him his regular Ironmonger hand. So again, you know, if you've had any of these Masher figures, you know the concept here. And again, all the parts are interchangeable. Also, there's the Transformer Masher line, which the parts work on these as well. So you can mix and match however you want. So that's my review. Overall, I like the set. I really like the Ironmonger figure. The classic Iron Man's okay. you know, we've had a lot of Iron Mans in this line, but definitely if you're trying to build like a Hall of Armor or something for your Masher figures, the classic Iron Man will make a nice addition to the other, you know, figures that have been released. The Ironmonger figure will go nicely with that Red Centurion Iron Man if you previously picked that one up. And this set is hitting retail shelves now, so I found it at Target, but you should be able to find it at any of the major retailers that carry Mashers, which is pretty much all of them. So that's my review. I hope you liked the review. If you're so inclined, please like the video, leave a comment, let us know what you think, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. And until next time, I'll catch you later.